Hi, I'm Wendy Cozell. I'm the District Health Coordinator for Davis County Schools.
And I'm Galen Lyle, District Nurse for Owensboro City Schools.
And we are here to talk about the new immunization or school shot requirements for the 2018-2019 school year.
The immunization laws updated by Kentucky this year were really needed because our state was not up to some other states as far as what was required for school age shots. And these are like your Tdap, your MMR, a lot of things that you did for when the children were babies. And when they started school, they needed new immunizations or updates or boosters. And that's what this is a new update to what is needed or a booster that is needed now.
So what this means for you is that basically every student in the state of Kentucky is going to need an updated immunization certificate with some updated immunizations. The first two are the hepatitis A series.
And the other shot is the meningitis booster. Now there are ages, as Wendy was saying, everyone is going to need two hepatitis A immunizations, which unfortunately have to be given over a 6-month time frame. So it's not a situation where you can just go once and get everything taken care of. The meningitis immunization, however, is only the booster that they're requiring that's new. It's for ages 16 and up.
Your primary care provider will be able to administer all those vaccinations for you. We're the Green River District Health Department, and there are other facilities that are going to be offering a few of the boosters as well.
Depending on the type of insurance you have or whether or not you have insurance that covers immunizations will impact where you're able to go and get school shots or especially these shots. For example, if you are on a state subsidized healthcare plan, or if you do not have insurance at all, you probably would need to contact the local health department, because paying for immunizations straight out at a private, let's say, clinic or provider could cost several hundred dollars.
If you have any questions about where you need to be going for your immunizations, please feel free to call either one of us or your individual school nurse, and we will be glad to point you in the right direction and to assist you in getting these done in a timely manner.
And also one other thing, if you do have insurance that covers immunizations and it's not a state subsidized, like a Medicaid type insurance, you have a lot of options outside of the primary care provider you have. Many of the pharmacies and several of the freestanding clinics will be carrying these immunizations. And as Wendy was saying, there's more information on the OPS and Davis County Public Schools websites that can give you an idea of where to start. And you really do need to do this now and get going, because there's a lot of factors at play and immunizations could become a little scarce closer to time of school starting next year.